Linear algebra lecture 9 on problems of LD and LI sets and basis. Yesterday already we have discussed about the problems of LD and LI sets. Now I am going to solve some other problem different to this problem, right? And so I want to define basis and I want to solve some problems on basis. So this is lecture 9 by Dr. P. Ramlu, Head Department of Mathematics, MVS Government Arts and Science College, Mahabubnagar. Okay. So verify the following or LDR LI sets. Verify the following or LDR LI sets. These sets has given s is equal to 1 x x square x cube, subset of equal to p3 over r, s is equal to 1 t 2 t square, subset equal to p2, 1 t square t 4 4, subset equal to p 4 4, s is equal to 1 plus t comma t square, subset equal to p 2 over r, s is equal to 1 comma t square, 1 plus 2 t, 1 plus 3 t square, subset of p 2 over r. So that's why he has defined these many sets. Okay, so 8 9 sets. So is defined. We want to find that whether the sets are LI or LD sets. So what is LI LD set? Yesterday I already discussed, but I am revising. What is LI and LD? Okay. V over A be a vector space. V over A be a vector space. S, I am taking that S is equal to some V1, V2, V1, V2, Vn, right? Each is subset of equal to V, so equal to V, right? E set to be LI if linearly dependent set, if so the relation A1 V1 plus A2 V2 dash 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 plus AN VN plus AN VN equal to 0, that is 0 vector, which implies A1 A2 that equal to AN equal to 0, then this set is called linearly independent set, right? A set is a set of linear dependent. If this implies, then A1 equal to A2 equal to AN equal to 0. If this relation satisfies, then compulsory the values of A1, A2 are must be 0. Then only we said that this is LI set. LD set. If S is equal to this set, V over S is this. If there exist some non-zero scalars, so all are not A1, A2, AN, all not zero, such that this is equal to, right? There exist a scalars, all are not zeros, such that A1, A2. That means, so here, some of them may be 0, or all are maybe, all are not equal to 0. Suppose here, this is not equal to 0, rest are 0. Some of this also not equal to 0, maybe rest of all are zeros. Some of therefore, maybe all are not 0. Maybe all are not 0. Some of may be zeros, right? If it exists some members, so A1, A2 or AN, such way that which are satisfied with the relation, then S is called linearly dependent set. Now, yeah, so these problems I want to solve, right? 1, x, x square, subset equal to p3 over r. We want to verify that whether this is linearly dependent set or linearly independent set. S is equal to 1 x x square x cube, right? So he asked me to that we have to verify that 1 x x square x cube, this is S, okay, which is subset R equal to P3. Right, this is equal to P3 over R, what will make, right? So I want to verify that this S is equal to 1 x x square is whether Li or Ld. Okay, you can take that P3 over R, what may be. So for that, what I took, I want to consider that to A1 x anything but 1. This is counting, you can take that this is V1, V2, V3, V4. A1 into 1, A2 into x, A3 into x square, A4 into x cube. That equal to 0 bar. This is polynomial vector space, which means 0 bar nothing but it is in the form 0 into set up all polynomial of degree 3. That means it is has up to degree 3. That means this polynomial contains up to third degree polynomial. That means we can write 0 into 1 plus 0 into x plus 0 into x square plus 0 into x cube, like this. So that means these two values, right, this I'm equaling these values, right, the coefficients of this x and constant and x square x cube I want to equaling. Then what happen, what will get here, that equal to, which implies what will get here, a1 equal to 0 and a2 also 0 and a3 also 0, so a4 also 0. So which implies, so if I equaling that, all value 0. I am considering this relation, I get here a1, a2, a3 equal to 0. Therefore, the given set 1 x x square is linearly independent set. Okay. Oh, if I similarly, if I take the other set also, if I take another set, that means S is equal to, I am taking one other set, 1, right, S equal to 1. So, you can take that t square. There I am taking here of x, here I am taking that x, which is set up all polynomial of degree 2. That means, this is p2. This has to be subset called p2. Same, what you do that a1 into t, a1 into 1, a1 into t, a2 into t square, that equal to 0, but that equal to 0, but nothing but 0 into 1. 0 into t, 0 into t square. Okay, okay, what will get here? A1 equal to 0, A2 equal to, H3 equal to 0. Same will get there. Therefore, this is also a Li set. This is also linearly independent set. Now, I'm taking here other problem. I want to take other problem. Suppose, same I'm taking here. We want to verify that 1 comma t 1 plus t. So, one comma t, 1 plus t. Whether this set is, you can say this is set of all polynomial of degree r, right? That means so it has a polynomial of degree up to degree 1. Okay, 1 comma t comma, okay, 1 comma t comma 1 plus t, right? Yeah, if I take that 1 plus t is equal to 1 plus t is equal to what right here? Here 1 into 1 plus 1 into t. You may write this 1 plus t is written as a linear combination of its preceding vector. Linear combination of preceding vector. Therefore, this is LD set. This is LD set. If you are unable to see, so you can do what you do. If you want to solve that, you can take, you use similar method only. So here you write that a1 times 1 plus a2 times t plus a3 times 1 plus t. Equal to 0 bar, which implies what happened here? 0 bar nothing but 0 plus 0 into 1, yes, sorry, 0 into 1 here, 0 into 1 nothing but 0 into 1 plus 0 into t. This is 0 bar nothing but like this. What you will get here? So a1 plus a3 the constant term plus a2 plus a3 into t, that equal to same value, this value, right? So which implies what happened here? A1 plus a1 plus a3 equal to 0, and a2 plus a3 also 0, which implies what happened here? Here a1 equal to minus a3, minus a3, that equal to here a2 equal to minus a3, minus a3 equal to nothing but a2. You will get this. So you can take that a2 is equal to 1. If a2 equal to 1, minus a3 equal to what happened? 1, a3 equal to minus 1, a2 equal to 1 equal to 1. Therefore, there are these scalars 1, minus 1, sorry, 1, 1, minus 1. So that which is satisfied this equal to, that means so here all are not zeros. Here I consider this relation, if I consider the relation, I got here constant to some number. So therefore, given set is linearly dependent set. Given set is a linearly dependent set. So therefore, similarly, we have to prove this kind of method using this method the following problems. Okay. S is equal to 1 x x square, already just now solved. So from considering this 1 into x, this equal to a equal to 0, b equal to c equal to d equal to 0. Therefore, S is a linear dependent set. Yes, similarly, I am taking this set a into 1, b into t, c into t square, that equal to 0 into 1, 0 into t, 0 into t square. This also linear independent set. If I consider this set, s equal to 1, t, t, t 4, 4, what I am doing here, a1 into t, a2 into t square, a3 into t 4, 4, that equal to, it is in the form of 0, 0 into t square, 0. We can write this 0 vector in the form of 0 into 1, 0 into 2, 0 into t, 0 into t square, 0 into t cube, but not required, I am writing, not reading. You can write this. If I compare this question, then what happened? A1 equal 0, A2 equal 0, A3 equal 0. Therefore, S is linearly independent set. Okay, S is equal to 1 plus t, t square, A into 1 plus t, A2 is equal to 0 into t, 0 into t square, plus 0 into 1 also. Then what happened here? Here A1 A plus A2, that means A1 equal to 0, A2 equal to 0. Therefore, there exists A1 equal to 0, A2 equal to 0, that this here. Therefore, S is linearly independent set. If I take this set 1 comma t, t square, 1 plus 2t, 1 plus 3t square, 1 plus 2t plus 3t square is equal to 1 into 1. this vector 1 plus 2t square plus 3t, not here, separate vector, 1 plus 2t plus 3t square, 1 plus 2t square written as 1 into 1, 2 into t, and print this vector is a linear combination of its preceding vector. This vector is a linear combination of its preceding vector. So therefore, one vector is a linear combination of other vector, then S is linearly dependent set. If I take 1, 2, t, t square, 3, t square, then we can apply here, compare coefficients, we will get a1 equal to 0, a2 equal to 0, a3 equal to 0, a4. Therefore, if I construct the relation, I got here a1 equal to 0, a2 0, a3 equal to 0, a4. Therefore, this is linearly independent set. You can observe here, 5, 70, 80 square, 90 square, 9 plus 84, 4 plus 5 t power 5. Okay, so what I got here, if I solve this equation, so I will get here a1 0, a2 0, a3 0, a4, a4, 5 0. So therefore, it is linearly independent set. If I take this 1 x, x square, x square to x power 2019, so the coefficients of x power 2019. So that equal to 2019, 2019. So I am gotten what I took here, a1, a2, that's why a20, x power 2019. So that means a1 0, a2 0, a3 0, as a20, 20 equal to 0. They exist. All are zeros such that this, therefore, S is linearly independent set. So similarly, this kind of problems already we solved so many things. You can just simplify, multiply and do is equating 0, then we'll get one of the values or zeros. So these are our linearly dependent set, independent set, right? So again, I'm taking that. Suppose S is equal to a11, a12, a1n, comma a21, a22, that is a2n, or an1, an2, that is an. Maybe you take like that, or you can take also, you may take that a11, a12, a1n, a21, a22, a2n. ANN, AN2, ANN, like that also you may take. So this is our the row vector, these are column vectors, same vector I am writing in the form of rows, columns. If I take like this, subset of VN or RN over, you can take anything, right? If I take that, this is another method for solving the whether this is linear independent set or dependent set. So if determinant of a11, a12, a1n, a21, a22, a2n, ann, an2, that is ann, is not equal to 0, then S is linearly independent set. So what you do, you can find determinant for this of elements, okay, the determinant of the matrix is not equal to 0, then we say that S is linearly independent set. If determinant of the matrix equal to 0, then S is linearly dependent set. This is work for only square matrices. It works for only square matrices, not for other matrices. If it is take square matrices, right? determinant is not equal to 0, I say that S is linearly dependent set. Determinant 0, then we say that S is linearly dependent set. The converse of above statement need not be true. Converse of above statement need not be true. That means, if I take determinant 0, S is linearly dependent set need not be determinant is equal to 0. Or S is linearly independent set determinant is need not equal to 0. That means, suppose S is equal to 2, 1 is linearly dependent set. But determinant of 2, 1 is not defined. If I take S equal to 2, 4, 0, it is not defined. Is LI set, determinant is not defined. So, is also LI set, determinant is not defined. That means, if you suppose determinant, linear independent set, linear independent, but determinant may not be defined for that matrices. So, that means, it is work for only square matrices, not rectangular matrices. So, verify that the following sets are LI or LD. So, I want to apply the matrices formula. So, by using that, I want to verify these vectors, these sets are linearly independent or linearly dependent sets. S is equal to 1, comma 2. I am taking this S is equal to this. First one is going to observe 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. Already we show that this is linearly independent set. I want to show now by using by the determinant property. Determinant 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. That equal to this. This is triangular matrix. Determinant of triangular matrix equal to product of elements of diagonal. Therefore, this product is 1. Which is not equal to 0, therefore S is linearly independent set. So, for entrance purpose, it is very useful for entrance purpose. It is very useful. Why? Because shortcut method work for saving times. If it is come examination, you have to use solve by definition only. But in entrance, you can use this problem. If it is right, so 1 2 3 3 4 1 1 7 8. 1 2 3 3 4 1 1 7 8. S is equal to 1 2 3 3 4 1 1 7 8. S is equal to this thing, right? I want to multiply 1 2 3 3 4 2 3 1 7 8. So, sorry. Here 7, right? 1 3 1 2 3 3 4 1 1 7 8. You could do this matrix 1 2 3 3 4 1 1 7 8. If I do this determinant, I got is not equal to 0, therefore S is linearly independent. That what I will multiply here 1 into 3 into 4 into 8 equal to 32 minus 7 minus 3 into 2 into 4 equal to 16, 3 into 7 equal to 21 plus 2 minus 12, that equal to 25. This is 25, this is minus 5, this is minus 10. If I multiply adding this, 25 minus 15, 40 minus 10, 30, 30 not equal to 0. Therefore, this is linearly independent. If I take this, 200, 201, 312, 47 matrices. If I do matrices, if I determine, find determinant, here I am getting 5. The 5 is not equal to 0. Therefore, this is linearly independent set. You can take the 3, 4, 1, 2. If I do find determinant, what happened? 6 minus 4 to not equal to 0, this is linear differences. 1, 6, 2, 3, 6 minus 6 equal to 0, therefore this is linearly dependent set. 6 minus 6, what you can observe here? 6 minus 6 equal to 0. Therefore this is linearly dependent set. 2, 4, 1, 2, that means 4 minus 4 equal to 0, therefore this is the linearly dependent set. Here I am taking that 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that is, if a determinant is not equal to 0, therefore, S is linearly independent set. Show that the set 1 comma is linearly dependent C over C, but linearly independent set in C over R. So very important that. Show that the set 1 comma is linearly dependent set in C over C, but linearly independent set in C over R. So you can see what happened here. So I want to take that. The set S is equal to, he asked me to find that 1 comma I, right? Okay, the set S is linearly li in li in C over okay, C over C. This set is LD in C over C. Next, I want to show that what can I show that? But linearly independent in C over R. Linearly independent in C over R. Li in C over, I want to show this. So this set is LD in C over C and Li in C over R. Why? What is happening here? What is the order in here at home? If there exist non-zero scalars, at least all are not just square A1, it says that A11 into A2 I equal to 0. So this is that it is linearly dependent. If A11 into A2 I equal to 0, which implies A10, A20, then we say that that is linearly independent set. So that means I want to consider here. So A1. Into 1 plus A2 into I. Into 0 bar. This vector set. If I take this, my vector space is so this. If I take the vector space is C over C. For what values of C over C it will be there? That means here, see the elements of A1, A2, right? Here, these elements, yes, scalar, there is scalars, right? This A1, here A1, comma A2, or belonging to this is subset of C, right? This is subset of C. This element belongs to C field. Yes, my field is so C. So here my field is C. A1 comma A2 plus C. I'm writing that considering this A1i A1 into 1 A2i equal to 0 power, which implies A1 into 1 A2i equal to 0 power, which implies what can I take here? A1 into 1 plus A2i that equal to A1 into 1. So for what values of A1 and A2 this equation will be satisfied. If it is right 0, A1 0, A2 0 is equal to satisfies. Is it like? But I was told that LD is LD, right? For what values of A1 comma A2 I want to, right? If I substitute A1 is equal to minus I. Here, if I substitute A1 is equal to minus I, you can substitute A2 is equal to 1. Then what happen? Minus I into 1 equal to minus I plus I equal to 0 bar. These are element belonging to C. Okay. These are element belonging to C. A1 equal to minus I, A2 equal to 1 belonging to C. Therefore, this is linearly dependent set. A1 equal to 0. Not only this, you can take that A1 equal to someone, A2 is equal to I. You can also ask twice. So like that, you will get infinite number of values. That's why there exist non-zero scalars, all non-zero A1, A2, such that A1i plus A2i equal to 0 bar. Therefore, this S is linearly independent set. Linearly dependent set. If I take my vectors are in C over R, that means if I in place of C over C, if I take this is belonging to R, A1 comma A2 belongs to R, then what happen? A1 comma A2, if I take A1 comma A2 belongs to R, so same value taking, which implies for what values of A1, right? What values of A1, A2, it satisfies relation. I must take that either A1i, A2i, that means the elements of A1 comma A2i is in the form of I only. If I take any real number, it not satisfies this relation. If you take here either A1 complex number or A2 complex number, then only it is satisfied, right? That means if I take this in R, which implies it must be A1 equal to 0 or A2 equal to 0 only. If I take my real field, then what happens? If I take C over R, my scalars are real. So, in real case, what if I take A1 0, A2 equal to, it satisfies. Otherwise, not satisfying. We'll get on complex number. Complex number does not belong to real numbers, right? See, this belongs to C but not belongs to R. That's why. So, A1 equal to 0 is therefore. If I take this set in C over R is linearly dependent. If I take this set in C over C, it is linearly independent. It is a beautiful example, right? So it is entrance also, it is coming. So we can understand the concept of linearly independent set and linearly dependent set. That's why. So this set is, so if I take subset of C only, A1, if I consider A2i, so we will get A1 equal to minus I, A2 equal to 1. This belongs to C. That's why I am taking C over C is this set is linearly dependent C over C. But A1 minus I, A2 does not belong to R, because complex number does not belong to R. That's why A1, you have to take that A1 equal 0 and A2 equal 0. Therefore, S is linearly dependent set. S is linearly independent set in C over R. So that's why here I want to explain. Uh, I want to explain. Yes, s is equal to 1 comma I. You can take that s is equal to 1 comma I subset of c, and a1 into 1 plus b1 into I equal to 0 bar. There exists to a equal to 1, b is equal to minus I belonging to c such that a1 into 1 b1 equal to c. Therefore, s is so linearly dependent since u over r. But this does not belong to R. It implies a equal to 0, b equal to 0 only. That is, S is linearly dependent set in C over R. Single term is linearly independent in C over R. Single term one is linearly independent in R over R. Already studied with any non-zero vector is a linearly independent set in R, any vector space. Here I am taking that one is linearly independent. If it's not equal to 0, then it is linearly independent set in R over R. If I take 0, if I consider single term 0, if you know already, you know that if any set which has zero element, it is linearly dependent set. If I take any vector set which is containing zero element, that is linearly dependent set. 100 is linearly independent set in R2 over R. E1 comma E2 comma E3, where E1 equal to this, E2 equal to this, E3 equal to this, is linearly independent set in R3 over R. Or you can take that either E1 equal to 100, E2 equal to 0, 010, E3 equal to 001, is linearly independent set in R3 over R. Here, E1 comma E2 comma data of EN is linearly independent set in R1 over R, where E1 is equal to 1000 and 100, E2 equal to 0100, E3 equal to like this, so, okay, that is EN equal to 001 or 000, you can take like this. But take that 1 comma x square data section, or can take that 1 t, t square, t4 and is linearly independent set in Pn over R. If I take 1 comma x comma x square, okay, like this is linearly independent set in P over R. That is, a set has infinitely many vectors. Okay. If I take that 100, 010, 00, if I take, is linearly independent set in M2 cross 2 over R. So this is the linearly independent set M2 over R. If I take that all matrix, you can put here 1, you can change, replace 1, you can change, replace 1. That means I am changing 1 to all elements, so therefore it is also linearly independent set in M3 cross 3 over R. If I take nth vector, so n cross n matrices, so this is linearly independent set of n cross 4. You can take it also if I rectangular matrix also it's work. Why? Because it's also linearly representative for rectangular matrix also. You can take that this mn cross n also it is work. Okay. Yeah, take that this 1 comma 0 0 comma is linearly independent n to n comma m1 comma 2 over r. Or you can take that r2 over r. If I take this is linearly independent set m2 cross 1 over r2, right? So if I therefore so this matrix is is linearly independent set M2 cross 2 over R. This is rectangular matrices, right? That's just to, I'm simply replacing one in place of 0. Okay, moving. Here, in fact, this set also is linearly independent set M3 2 cross 2. If I take this, my M cross N matrix, M cross N matrix, M is linearly independent set in M cross N over R matrix. If I take this matrix 100, 001, 00, 00 is n cross m matrix, is n cross n is linearly independent set in m n cross m over r matrices. So, single term is linearly independent subset of q over q, r over q, r over r, c over r, c over q, c over q. It's linearly independent subset of these all sets. Every vector space has infinitely many linearly independent subset of into linearly dependent subsets. If I take any vector space, it must has infinitely many vectors have infinitely many linearly independent sets as well as linearly dependent sets, right? This ends the base linearly independent topic and linear right? So now I am going to explain basis. Okay, what is basis, right? So, basis involves these definitions. We have to use this definition in basis also. Now, I am going to explain basis. what is basis? Let S is equal to V1 comma V2 dot Vn be a non-empty subset of vector space V over F. S is said to be basis of V if S is linearly independent subset of. Second one is L of S is equal to V, or you can take the span S. You can say that span equal to V1, V2, Vn. Right? So I'm taking that. Let S is equal to V1 comma V2 comma dot Vn be a non-empty subset of vector space V over F. List of S is said to be basis of V if first one is S is linearly independent set, second one is L of S is equal to V. Okay, L of S is another span S. Span S nothing but span of V1 we have to data Vn. This thing I would like to right. So you can understood that let us be a non empty subset of vector space V over F. S is said to be basis of vector space V over F if S is linearly independent set to second one L of S equal to V. That equal to span S is equal to span of V1, V2 that is Vn. Or let V over F be a vector space and H is subspace of U. Let B equal to V1, V2 that is Vn be a non-empty subset of H. E is said to be basis for H if B is the linearly independent set to H is equal to span of V1, V2 that is Vn. That is span B coincide with H. Span B coincide with H. This means span B coincide, right? So then we'll write okay, both are same but notation is different. I would like to use first definition only for solving the problem, right? Okay, okay, what is basis? Okay, what is basis? So I'm taking this too. So S is equal to V1, V2, so is a non-empty subset of a vector space V over F. Vector space V over F. This set is said to be linearly independent subset. If first one, I want to verify that S is linearly independent set. So already we discussed about the linearly independent set. Now also, I want to verify that whether the given set is linearly independent or not. Second one, L of S is equal to L of S is equal to V. So this thing I would like to verify. That means I want to take that. I want to verify that given set is which subset of V first condition. Second condition is first one, I want to say that S is linear independent, second is L of S equal to V. So, this thing I would like to verify. Okay. For example, simply I am taking one set, S is equal to 1, comma 0, 0, comma 1. So, this set, example. I'm taking this example of whether this set is linearly independent set or not. First of all, we have to verify. Why? Because this is subset of equal to R2. This element belongs to R2. I would like to verify this is linearly independent or not. For that, what could I take here? I want to take that. This is here V1, V2. Already we know that this is linearly independent subset, right? Of R2, okay? Again, I want to verify the first one is linearly independent. That means what can I take that? Simply that A1 times. event types are 1 comma 0 a2 times, so this is plus a2 times, so 0 comma 1 0 bar that equal to 0 comma 0, which implies what happened? This, if I multiply add, we will get that a1 0 a 0 a2, that equal to, if I add this thing, a1 a2 equal to 0 comma 0, which implies what happened here? A1 equal to 0, A2 equal to 0, A1 0, A2 0. Therefore, S is Li. What can I say here? S is Li. S is linearly independent set. Second one, already know that, we know that L of S is subspace of V vector space. Let your vector space is not certain, L of S is subspace of your. That's why subspace at the part, first of all, it is subset of V. Okay? So, subspace of at the part, V. L of S subspace equal to V. So, this is, I know. I'm taking this is one. Second condition, what can I take? I want to take to one element in V. I want to write that this is linear combination of elements of S. That means that element belongs to L of S. Then what can I show that V is subset equal to L of S. Okay. So I want to take that over some element to X comma Y belonging to V. So I'm taking this element to is belonging to, this element belongs to V. So so that equal to, I'm writing X, so I'm writing here 1 comma 0 plus Y into 0 comma 1. X comma Y equal to X into 1 comma 0 plus Y into 0 comma 1. So if this element, this belongs to V1 and this is belonging to V2, right? This is V2. That means these vectors are in S. That means it is a linear combination of S, elements of S. That means this element belonging to L of S. X comma Y belonging to L of S. So therefore, what happened here? Here what happened? L of S, so V subset equal to L of S. This is 2. L of S equal to 2. This is 2. From 1 and 2, what can I write here? L of S equal to L of S is equal to V. So, second is proved, right? So, I put that S is Li, second is L of S equal to V. Therefore, S is linear, S is basis of vector space or 2 over R, we can show, right? So, this is basis concept. So, I would like to explain. Let R over R is a basis, V a vector space. I am taking S is equal to 1, singleton 1. Clearly, we know that any non-zero vector is a linearly independent set. This is clearly linear independent set. Second one, L of S is subspace of V, which implies L of S subspace equal to V. This is 1. I am taking A belongs to V, which implies A equal to A dot 1. That is linear combination of vectors of 1. So, therefore, A belongs to L of S. So, A belongs to V and A belongs to L of S. Therefore, V subspace equal to L of S. From 1 and 2, I am taking that L of S equal to V. Therefore, this is basis for So that means I want to show that this is basis for our first one. I am talking that linear independent set. Second one is I want to show that L of S is equal to Y. Since L of S is subspace of U or F, that's why I am writing here subspace nothing but L of S is equal to V. Okay. Second one, I am taking an element to in V. A belongs to V. It implies A equal to V turned as A into 1. Nothing but A into 1 nothing but it is a linear combination of elements of 1 because 1 belongs to S. So that means this element belongs to L of S. Therefore, A belongs to V, which implies A belongs to L of S. Which implies what right here V sub zero equal to L of S 2. From 1 and 2 V written as L of S equal to V. This is this. Similarly, you can show that this is the base for Q over Q, R over Q, C over Q. Okay. Is 1 is base for C over question mark, right? I am writing A belongs to C, which implies A into that equal to 1, right? But A is in does not belongs to O. I am writing A belongs to C, A belongs to C, which implies A written as A into 1. It will look like that this is a product of linear combination of elements, but this A is C, but A is not in R, right? That's why L of S is not equal to V. Therefore, 1 is not basis for C over R. Similarly, 1 is not basis for R over Q. Okay. I am taking that S is equal to 1 comma I. S A to 1, please I, B I, A equal to 0, B equal to 0, S is linear independence of U over R. Clearly, L of S is equal to of R equal to V. And X equal to A, X equal to A plus Y. That means A into X space. That means this X and Y in R is a linear combination of S. Therefore, A belongs to L of S. So, it is linear combination of A belongs to L of S. Therefore, S is such a equal to L of S. From I and 2, I show that L of S is equal to C. Therefore, S is linearly independent of set of U and L of S equal to C. S is equal to 1 comma is basis for C over R. So, I am verifying that this is basis for C over R. 1 is not basis for C over R, but 1 comma is basis for Y because we have shown that this is linear independent set to second is L of S equal to C. That's why it is basis. Show that 1 comma 0 0 comma 1 that is R 1 comma 0 is basis for R to R. Just now we shown that S is equal to 1 comma 0 0 comma 1 A into 1 comma 0 plus A to 0 comma 1 that equal to 0 A1 into 0 plus 0 into A2 that equal to 0 comma 0 A1 comma A2 equal to 0 comma 0 which implies A1 comma 0 and A2 comma 0. There exist to A1 comma A2 such that A1 equal to 0. Therefore S is linearly independent subset of R to R. Okay, simply already you know that this is linear independent set. Second one, clearly L of S subset of Y because L of S subset of R equal to R2, any linear combination subset of R2, already we know that, that is, I am taking A comma B last, I am taking R2. A comma B is equal to as A into 1 comma 0 and plus B into 0 comma 1. That means, this is the linear combination of elements of S. This element belongs to L of S. Therefore, R2 subset of R equal to F S. From 1 and 2, I am writing here L of S is equal to R2. There S is equal to 1 comma 0, 0 comma 0 is base for R2 over R. 1 comma 0 comma 0, 0 comma 1 comma 0, 0 0 1 is equal to 1 0 0. 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1 is basis for R3 over R. 1, comma 0, comma 0, 0, comma 1, comma 0, 0. Therefore, 0, comma 0, as 1 is basis for Rn over R. Note, E1, comma E2, comma data Cn is standard basis for Rn over R. And Q1 or Cn over C, where is E1 equal to this, this is standard basis for Rn over R. You can take that. This standard basis for R1 over R, this is standard basis for R3 over R, this is standard basis for Rn over R. If I take this E1, E2, dash Cn is standard basis for Rn over R, Qn over Q, Cn over C. Sorry, this is wrong here. Yeah. Cn over C only, not Cn. This is not filled by because, right? Where E1 equal to 0, this E2 equal to this, and E3 equal to this. You can show that 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0 is basis for M2 cross F. That's why I am taking S is equal to this. So, if I take that A1, A2, A3, if I add in multiply, we will get finally with A1, A2, A3, A4, that equal to 0, 0. So, it implies there exist A1, A2, A3, A4 equal to 0, such that this equal to 0, therefore S is linearly independent subset. Next one, clearly I know that L of S could subscribe to M2 cross F. Let A, comma B, comma C, comma D subscribe to M2 cross 2. Therefore, A, B, C, D that equal to written as so, A times if I take A comma not 100, B take comma not 0010, C comma not this you can read like this. These elements are the elements of S. These are the linear combination elements of S. These are this belongs to L of S. Therefore, ABCD belongs to M2 cross 2 over F, which implies ABCD belongs to L of S, which implies M2 cross 2 over F, such as called L of S. From 1 and 2, L of S is equal to M2 cross 2 over F. Therefore, S is basis for M2 cross 2 over F. Right? Similarly, you can show that 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, this is basis for M3 over 3. Again, this also basis for Mn cross over F. And this is basis for M2 cross 2. This is 1, 0, 0. Already we explained that this is a linear independent subset of that. Here, these are the standard basis. These are the standard basis of Mn cross n over F. Here, this is also basis for M cross n over F. This is standard basis for, right? So, this is basis for 1, 0, 0, 0. This is basis for M3 cross 2 over F, right? So, this thing I would like to explain, already explained. Just not today topic, already I discussed about the linear independence and problems and linear independent problem. I explained just basis definition. I proved some standard basis. I would like to prove some other basis also. Tomorrow class I will prove some other basis also. So thank you for listening this class. Thank you very much.